try and whisper as much as I can today, but I'm not very good at the whispering thing, so I will try. I'm still wondering whether I talk too quietly sometimes. I apologise for the look. I've not got a lot of makeup on, but I don't care. Today I've got a toad in the hole, which is sausages in the orchard pudding, mashed potato with some peas and green beans and gravy. You can't really see it, but see that you don't see the top of my head. Do you see the food? It's really up to you guys, I don't know. A bit better. Getting over a little bit more. There we go. That's a little better. The Christmas tree in the background. Very festive. Very warm. So these are just leftovers from yesterday. And I thought, okay, saying I've got to make a video to myself. It's been ages since I've made a video. And now you start feeling a bit guilty, thinking, oh, this one I made a really good video. I desperately want to do pie and mash. It's just like an East End thing, pie and mash with liquor. I don't think I've seen anybody actually do that, but I really want to do that one. It with the knife and fork in the wrong hand, you're not imagining things. But I've always done it ever since I was a child. Just, I'm not going to change now. Oh god, they're building over the back. I'm sorry if you can hear that. It's probably going to be a little noisy, I don't know. Hopefully not. Everybody ready for Christmas? I'm getting there. Considering this is like Thursday, I've got till next Tuesday. Thing is, my husband and I obviously split up, and so it's like the first Christmas on my own with my three girls. He's seeing the youngest on Boxing Day. What we've agreed, it's fine. But it's been a bit of a struggle to try and get all the Christmas presents for everyone. It's like, financially, I just said to the girls, you know, I can do what I can do, and they're fine with it, absolutely, obviously. They, you know, they're not babies anymore. I'm just lucky that I've got a good job where, because obviously my health hasn't been great, I've managed to be off work, also get full pay. The good news is I'm feeling much better and I go back to work in January. I'm a bit nervous because it's been August, I've been off since, so that's quite a long time, but I've done the job for long enough, I know what I'm doing, it's just the anxiety of it all. We've got my middle daughter. She wanted an upgrade on her contract for her phone, so we've managed to get her that. But because I've been waiting around to get my ex-husband to sort that out, because it's in his name, so the upgrade would have to be in his name, we've been waiting to see how much we've got to pay off on the old contract. unless it transpires that we don't actually have to buy anything, because her old phone will take care of that, which is great. But it means that I've been sort of waiting and waiting to find out if I've got to pay anything, and now I haven't. I can't get presents for her. And I feel so guilty because the other two girls, the oldest and the youngest, I've basically sorted. And the middle one, I feel like I'm sort of like running around grabbing stuff. Like, it's just crazy. I mean, I've just ordered her a nice little tracksuit from Misguided, which I think she'll like, because, you know, they're all into this teddy bear fleece and, like, effort stuff, you know, bedding and clothing and coats and God knows what. So I just ordered her a tracksuit, bottoms and a top. Like to say a little bit of a shout out to Lisa. I feel for her because I know what she's going through. It's so hard, and sometimes you feel like you're sort of really on your own, but you're never on your own. There are always people around, and they come at the most unlikely places as well. Like YouTube and, you know, other places. It's so weird. And you always think that you're so alone and, you know, the house feels empty, especially when the kids go to bed at night. But it's really weird. Like, it's taken me a long while to get used to being alone. Sort of being strong enough. But you get there. And Christmas will be hard, it will be for me, I know, but yeah, you'll be okay. And sending my love, really. Just want to let you know that you're not the only one out there. Sorry about the squeaking on the plate. I'm trying to keep it to a minimum. There, I can do that again. But I'm trying. Great ASMR video, Claire. Pepsi Max. Thank you. I feel like I've lived and blooming takeaways the last few days. So it's quite nice to have something with vegetables. It's hard work. When you're out and about and you're doing things, you're busy. When you come home, you're like, oh, stuff it. Let's order a pizza or go to McDonald's. I really thought that was going to go to help me then. That's really nice, that was. It's lunchtime. Shouldn't really be eating a full meal, but I'd only go to waste otherwise. So, Christmas Eve. I'm going out with my youngest daughter. My best friend and I are going to spend some time together. Take our youngest two out. We're going to go for lunch at the local pub. Booked a table. And then we're going to go and see Cats at the cinema. My friend is really excited. Pardon me. She loves musicals. She did like musical theatre and that. Gave it up when she got pregnant, and she was 21, which was a bit sad really, because she's always regretted it. Not regretted, obviously, having a daughter, but regretted never sort of taking that step back into it. But that'll be a lovely day, because normally it's always been very organised by my ex-husband and his other children, so sort of dominated, and Christmas Day as well. And this year, Christmas Day, we're going to get up early, me and the girls, and open presents. And then my middle daughter has got to go to work. She works as a manager in our people's home, in the restaurant, which is a really la-di-da old people's home. They do silver service and everything. So she's management in the restaurant. Sitting working until 4, but I think it'll be lovely. But I mean, can't really knock it, she's getting triple time for it. So, but yeah, so we're gonna open the presents and she'll go off to work. And then myself and my other two daughters have a bit of breakfast and get ready. And then drop in my oldest daughter, yeah, she's 21, so I didn't expect her to be around the whole day. She's going to see her boyfriend and his family, so I'll drop her off, and then my youngest daughter, so is going to see her dad, spending the rest of Christmas Day with him. But I'm going up to my sister's and spending the day with her and her family, so I'm really looking forward to that. And I suppose have a few drinks and get merry and play some silly games. Bought a twerk bomb. And me and my youngest daughter were playing it last night. It was so funny. It was really hard. Like, it really hurts your hips where you're having to twerk so much to get the balls out of the box. It's hilarious. And I think it all depends on where you tie it as well, around your waist. But anyway, that'll be a giggle when we're drunk. So we're doing that, and then Boxing Day, all my girls are coming over to my sister's. My sister's got basically my family coming over, apart from my dad. That's another story. All my sisters will be there. I've got, well, the oldest one won't be, but I've got four sisters, so the other two will be over. So yeah, it should be should be a really good Christmas. I'm looking forward to it. So, on that note, I suppose I'd best let you all go and have a lovely Christmas. Enjoy. And hopefully I'll get round to doing the pie mash one in the new year. Try not to leave it so long, but I think you have to try and feel like you want to be in the mood to do it. Anyway, enjoy your Christmas, guys, and see you in the new year.